Hello and welcome back to the Guitar Collective. Today we have my 2004 Les Paul custom tobacco bust made by Epiphone. Now, the Les Paul is certainly one of the classics, and I'm a little bit biased when saying this because they're my all-time favorite guitars. So when I saw this come up, and I bought it from Facebook Marketplace, and it was such a bargain. The guitar itself was £230. And considering how capable these are, as you would have seen in the beginning intro riff there, it was too much of a good deal to pass up. Now, this is the first actual kind of Epiphone guitar that I've owned, other than Shane's white one, which I've played and owned for a while. But I am absolutely thrilled with this purchase, and I'm going to start off by saying that if you buy one of these, you will not be disappointed. It's probably one of the best made kind of budget guitars there is out there, and I've made it a personal goal of mine to collect all of them, which will never happen really. This is one of the best looking and best playing guitars that I've owned. So let's start off with a bit of the story. Obviously, I was doing the usual kind of scroll through Facebook Marketplace and came across this, £230, and it came with the case, which is honestly amazing. So I messaged the guy and arranged shipping, and the shipping was something like 60 quid, which is a lot, but I got it within 2 days and it needed a lot of cleaning up. You probably would have seen this on my new Guitar Day video. The link will be at the end of the video. And it needed a clean up and restring and everything else. But once I did that, it plays amazingly. So it's a 2004 version, which is kind of the golden era between 95 and then 2005 was probably the best series of Epiphone Les Pauls that there is. It's got the Probooker 2s in the bridge and the neck, and it's got such a versatile playing style and playing capabilities that you can play anything from country songs to blues to heavy metal. Although I will say one thing, which is that if you want to drop tune it, the lowest you could probably realistically go is C. It's got a 24.75 inch scale length, so it's actually quite short for a guitar. So once you do get to that C, the string gets slightly sloppy, obviously depending on what string gauge you get, but I wouldn't really go any thicker than say 11s or potentially 12s. So in terms of how it plays, it sounds amazing, and with the I think it's the 1960s style slim taper neck with a rosewood fretboard and trapezoid inlays, which most Les Paul customs have, other than say probably special editions, but they mostly have all of these block trapezoid inlays. Obviously you've got binding on the headstock, and I've taken the pickup cover switch off because in my opinion you don't need to hide a body like this, and pickguards don't belong on Les Pauls anyway. It didn't need much of a setup, just a change of strings and lowered the action a little bit, and all in all it's such a great guitar. It's got some scratches, a little bit of buckle rash on the back, but you don't look at the back of the guitar, you look at the front of the guitar, and this is a flamed maple top. I don't know how thick it is, but it certainly looks the part and it kind of dances in the light. So would I recommend one of these? Yeah, basically. If you're into the kind of thicker neck guitars and don't want to down tune to E or F or whatever the fuck, just try one. Basically, it's probably the easiest guitar to play. It's heavy at almost 9 pounds, but there are heavier ones there, like the triple pickup. Black Beauty is definitely heavier, you wouldn't want to be standing up playing it for too long. Now, what I like about this is it's got the gold hardware, which I think suits it perfectly, and obviously you've got Grover tuners at the back. And being Epiphone, you've got the poly finish, but it helps preserve the maple cap you've got on here. And just the wear and tear, it's an inexpensive guitar, so everything that you would usually expect to like scratch or fade just doesn't over the years. I mean, it's 2004, so it's 16 years old now, and it's almost like you've just bought it from the shop. So I guess we should try out some of the sounds. Are there things I don't like about this guitar? Well, no, to be plainly honest with you. It does take a bit of getting used to. The bridge saddles are quite sharp. It's got the usual tunematic style bridge. If you're not used to putting your hand where you usually put your hand, say on an Ibanez or something, which is much further back, you kind of have to change your playing style. Although most of the time these days it's on my other knee. Which is easy to play like that. The pickup covers do wear. Obviously these are the gold ones, but because of where my hand lays, my sweat just kind of degrades the plating away, but that's not too much of a big deal. It's got the fast action knobs, which I like. Some people change them out for top hats or the kind of aged see-through ones, but I like these. They're really easy to turn, really easy to access quickly. Not that I use them a lot, because it is what it is. One little bugbear is the pickup selector switch, which you might have noticed in the playing demo is the wrong way around. So usually the down position is the neck and the up is the bridge, but this is the ground. Up is neck and down is bridge, but I don't care. It stays in one or the other. I don't tend to change through them too much. The frets, I think they're medium jumbo, possibly. That wasn't available to see on the Epiphone website, but I think they are medium jumbo. The wear is minimal. I mean, I've been playing this flat out for probably about 3 months now, and there's not even any wear. Not that I'm that heavy-handed, but I'm more heavy-handed than some people. And yeah, basically everything is perfect on this guitar, and I would certainly recommend it for anyone who's looking to try out one of Epiphone's higher end models. You can pick these up for around £300 to £500. I got this one at a bit of a bargain, so it's easily obtainable. This finish is quite rare though, so if you do come across one, I'd snap it up pretty quickly. Thanks for watching The Guitar Collective. This was my 2004 Epiphone Les Paul Custom in Tobacco Burst. Would you please like and subscribe and leave a comment down below on possibly a guitar you'd like us to get hold of next. We have a few guitars lined up for this year, and make sure to watch the videos that are listed at the end of this video. And yeah, please help us out to get to at least 1,000 subscribers so that we can get that all important money, not being to be completely transparent with you.